Oh yes, I've been waiting for this for a long time. I didn't even realize the rework was out until yesterday. Garrod O'Quinnigan, the premier Irish bundle of sticksist. Oh no, Duffy, get out the way. Okay, you called for an invasion of Ireland by Germany. No one likes you. No one at all. Okay? The virgin anti-Protestant Ono Duffy versus the Chad all-Christian Garrod O'Quinnigan. It's just way better. Either way, the new series, Kaiser Redux, Ireland, Garrod O'Quinnigan, Altirina Hesheraga, which means Knights of the Rebirth, I believe it means. Oh, yes. I know I said I'd give Kaiser Redux a wide berth for a while, and I did. It's been a while since our last series as Italo-Balbo. Italo-Balbo shall be returning in this series. It'll be a national populist Europe, a legionarist Europe. Oh, I'm looking forward to it. Alrighty. What do we have here? Revamped Kaiser X3 for Armenia, National France, of course. Rex's expansion for Wallonia, Limbaugh's 40 fighters and Patton's successors expansion for the Central American Republic, now South African Republic. East Karelia Treaty, Harold Loeb's Utopian Technocratic CSA and the Ireland expansion. Finally, Ireland has some fucking content. Ireland doesn't really get content in mods. New Order has content for Ireland, but, you know, it's alright. You know, it lasts like, what, 3-4 years? Maybe a bit more. But yes, and Kaiserreich, the Kaiserreich Ireland content is not good at all. Kaiserreich doesn't even have any national populist slash, as far as I'm aware, the furthest right you can go in Kaiserreich is... Oh, what is it? I think it is Altirina Hesheraga, but I believe they're Pat Ott in the mod. I think you can get them in the 1942 elections, but they have no content, naturally. Oh, I'm looking forward. Kaiser Redux is such a slow mod to load. This, of course, is Ireland. Now, the Republic of Ireland. Come on, load. After countless years of arduous rebellion and weathering oppressive British rule, the Irish people won their freedom, but as one enemy was vanquished under the rose in their place, Michael Collins sits as president, eager to defend the independence of his nation at any cost. Yet his political enemies are many as the 1937 election approaches, violence is rife, and the Protestants and Ulster plot to make their move. Ireland is a powder keg, and it's only a matter of time till it explodes indeed. Also, the fact that there was even a monarchic path for Ireland is just weird. It's ewy. It's odd. Now... Republic of Ireland, Michael Collins' waning heroic personality. While Collins has managed to coast quite comfortably on his popularity ever since he was swept into power in 1921, Collins has been gradually losing his sway over the Irish people. Slightly turn this down. New Irish playlist on my SoundCloud, by the way. After more than a decade, many have grown tired of Collins, seeing him as nothing but an old relic kept in power only because of his status as a hero, not because of any concrete policy. With Ireland's economy worsening, Collins is going to have to prove to the populace that he still has policies to bring to the table. Daily political power gain, -0.05. Daily market liberal support, -0.02. Michael Collins is the saviour national hero of Ireland, with wide-scale popularity keeping him in power. Born in Cork, best county ever. Collins fought in the 1916 Easter Rising and afterwards became the president of the Irish Republican Brotherhood. During the conflict, he organised the IRA into an effective guerrilla force. Seeking to avoid the mistakes of 1916 and 1921, he was sent to negotiate the Anglo-Irish Treaty. Although by threatening to continue the conflict with German backing, he was able to acquire all 32 counties in the treaty, he was then unable to secure a republic, with the British fearing that an independent Irish republic would immediately become a German base. When he was expelled from Sinn Féin by Éamon de Valera, he managed to form his own party, Fine Gael, which quickly overtook Sinn Féin in popularity. After the British Revolution, he declared an independent Republic of Ireland and defeated a Unionist uprising in Ulster. Now with the Second Weltkrieg approaching, Collins advocates revitalising Ireland's economy and military in order to assert Ireland's independence. Beautiful. Now, a monarchist Irish nation once again. Blech. Shocking nearly all in the nation, De Valera and his group of... Well, I don't really have any problem with monarchism in Ireland, assuming it's a national monarch, like an Irish monarch. But the monarchic Ireland in this mod doesn't have a lot of content, so it's kind of a weird path. Shocking nearly all in the nation, De Valera and his group of conservatives have come together to recreate the monarchist system of old Nazi in nearly 700 years, mainly created to serve as a unifying force above the democratic system. This new monarchy shall be a far cry from the absolutists on the continent, but our eventual ruler shall be a king all the same, the uniting figurehead our disparate and divided nation sorely needs. Now with the groundwork laid, we must decide on the future of this reborn monarchy and all those that shall live under the new crown. A democratic mandate. Irish democracy has been preserved, and despite these hard times, the goals of the Easter Rising shall not falter. The original dream of a democratic Irish Republic shall continue on as new elections are prepared, with the major parties of the Oireachtas all being in the running, such as Fianna Fáil, Sinn Féin, the National Centre Party, and the returning incumbents from Fine Gael. We have given the people of Ireland their voices again, so now let these voices finally be heard. Ruby Isle. Ireland is free and the people rejoice, for the revolution has bathed this once emerald isle in a shade of wondrous red, from the fingers of County Cork to the islands off County Donegal, from the pristine forests of Clwyd Valley and the placid waters of the Black Lake to the hustle and bustle of Dublin itself. All of Ireland has embraced the revolution. Our island now stands shining and crimson, and the people are finally free in this paradise, a free Ruby Isle that sticks out like a Claret pearl amid the dark waves of the Atlantic. Éireann Gabhrá, beautiful. The threat across the aisle. Convicts port plus 5%, division defence on core territory plus 8%. Many hope the British Revolution would have marked the end of British imperialism in Ireland. However, the new syndicalist government in London has largely proven to be no different than the old royalists on the matter of wanting to control Irish affairs. We once thought that imperialism was only a symptom of Britain's monarchist system, but as the syndicalists continue all the old royalist tricks, we have now come to the inescapable conclusion that the desire to subjugate our Emerald Isle is simply within the Englishman's blood. Yeah, it's definitely within the blood and not just a consequence of geopolitics, leading many to be convinced that our rivalry with London will only end when Britannia has been wiped off of the face of the earth for good. Unravelling political scene. Daily political power gain minus 0.05, daily political power cost plus 0.05, stability minus 5%, daily syndicalist, social democrat and social conservative support plus 0.02. Fine Gael has enjoyed an almost unopposed hold on Ireland's democratic political system ever since the foundation of the Free Republic, but that has begun to change in recent years. Collins's old adversary Eamon de Valera has been steadily gaining more power within Ireland as the economic situation worsens under Collins's rule, and as Fine Gael's powers wanes, violent clashes between supporters of Fine Gael and Fianna Fáil have become more common. This swell in political violence has led to a significant increase in Sinn Féin's popularity, as Cathal Brugha's ideas gain more traction with the masses, branding themselves as a peaceful third way between De Valera and Collins. Additionally, public controllers of various ilks have been steadily clawing their way into political relevance, largely thanks to support from the Union of Britain and the American SBA. With all this in mind, the election of 1937 is set to be the most contentious one in recent memory, and if Fine Gael is to remain in their position of unchecked dominance, they will need to prove to the people of Ireland of their commitment to overhauling Ireland's stagnant economic and political scenes in order to end the troubles once and for all. I highly doubt Mike Collins would let the whole thing stagnate, but whatever, that's whatever. Now, the Ulster issue is stability minus 5%, resistance growth fees plus 10%. The territory of Ulster has been occupied by the Republic of Ireland ever since the British fell to revolution, and while we have tried to incorporate them into Ireland proper, they have not gone quietly. The status of Ulster remains contentious in the Irish political scene, and a permanent solution to the Ulster issue is needed if the Emerald Isle is to remain free from armed conflict. Fine Gael, market liberals, national liberalism. National liberalism describes the strand of mainline liberal thought that also espouses patriotism and nationalism, either civic or ethnic in form, tied inherently to their notions of liberty, equality, freedom and fraternity. Commonly more conservative or traditionalist than mainline liberalism, national liberals seek a society of order and protected freedoms, but many have been known to offer preferred treatments towards each regime's favourite citizenry. Regardless, national liberalism is a legitimate liberal ideology with roots in France, wider Europe and their colonial possessions abroad. Oh, here we are. Also, O'Quinnagon has some ridiculous... if you go for the widest expansionist goals for pan-Celtism, you get cores on Northern Italy, Turkey. It's just weird, and I will not be going for that, because it's just... it's just stupid. Why isn't it opening? God, it must be very laggy. Kaiser Helix is an incredibly laggy mod. Yeah. This is atrocious. I'm only at the bloody screen. You'd swear it was 1945, 5-speed. Come on. Oh my God, there we are. Okay, we're getting there. No, I think we're there. That was perfect. Is it still laggy? Return to Monk, oh my God. Now. Let's get Future of the Iron Watt. Either way, where is... It's actually a choice now. Wow. Following the German. The United Kingdom will be automatically restored if controlled by the AI to balance the forces of the Entente and the Third International. No, that's stupid. Where are the Italians? Where are you? Where are they? Oh, here we are. Wait, where's... God, there's so much shit here. Okay, first thing we need to do is just close that. Close that. Close that. Close that. Close that. Now, here we are, that'll... sorting things a bit. Yeah, alright, fine. Back up here. That's us, we haven't been given new political paths yet. Here we are, the new Pope. And I elected. There's some good options right there. You know, obviously, the three good ones are the Latin Union, the Russian alignment, and the Italian sphere of influence. I go for the Russian alignment. Yeah, see if we can join that. The future of the Iron Crown, what's this? That's weird. Blockchain Mezzogiorno. And what about Southern Italy? Here we are. The Legion takes power. Reunify peace with their northern neighbor, yes. Hopefully that'll work. Because when we were playing Balbon Kaiser Redux, still that mod. Oh man, that was such a good run. We had such a large navy. I was so looking forward to using it. But we had the second Garibaldi, and it said that he was going to unify with the North. But what he actually did was effectively annex the North instead of, you know, being absorbed by the North. So hopefully the fasci takes power. Actually, no, I'm not going to risk it. Let's get Mussolini. Conflict in Italy. I'm going to leave a lot of this alone. Yeah, we need a civil conflict there because we'll be invading them. That's all fine. That's fine. No, that's fine. I'm trying to go for a Nat Poppy orb. Norway, we can get what's his face. Yeah, Quisling. Sweden, we get Gillen Croc. That's fine. Yeah, here we go. Blooming Chaos. Who should we get? We're not going to go for the Solidarists because they're too democratic. Well, not too democratic, too capitalist. Yeah. Who can we get? I mean, someone like the Codriano or Valvo. Svinkov? I don't want to go Svinkov. Svinkov is generic. Maybe we'll get the Solidarists. Yeah, go on, we'll get the Solidarists. What song is this? Yeah, it's just long. Never mind. It's fine. Next. Baltic Germans and their duchy. That's fine. Baltic renewal. Yeah. Whose fault sake power is just way too cheesy, so. Just leave that default. Yeah, the Crimean insurgency is stupid though. Where's Falco? Which is the one which is just ridiculous. Never mind. Future of Serbia. Oh man, this is just a pain in the earth. Fourth Balkan War. Big as possible, with the exception of the Turks. Politics Bulgaria, yes. No one at the fucking Bulgarists. Well, is it all about accepting the... Yeah, I like a bit of randomness as well, though, so I might leave with that. Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
Oh.
Alrighty, here we are. Any additional national threats? I think there might be one. Defense of the Republic. Convicts, poor plus 10%. Division attack and defense on court. Territory plus 10% after 700 years of British rule. I love whenever you talk to an Irish person, right, and you ask them how long Ireland was ruled by Britain for, you will get varying answers, like with like several hundred years of difference. Ask one guy, oh, for 700 years, 800 years, 900 years, 1,000 years, 1,100, 1,200. Oh, it's the best thing ever. However, Britain and Canada still threaten Ireland. If it comes to war, the Irish people must be prepared to fight using their superior knowledge of the terrain and determination to protect their freedom. Sometimes there's like 500 years of a difference if you ask an Irish person how long we were under British rule for. Now, show me the folks here. I know that it's mostly not changed. The industry tree isn't changed. Army tree, or military tree, rather. It's pretty much just the political tree. Which is good, because that's what needed to be changed. Oh, damn. Oh yes, Luke Kelly, the best to ever do it. I hear like load the tree, I'm not even rolling. And now here we are. So, again, military tree unchanged, though the foxes do look lovely. That's the public controllers tree. That's the democratic tree. This is the political questions tree, economic tree unchanged, all 49 days. Maybe except maybe this one? Yeah, it's 35, and that's 40, yeah, okay. Yeah, 35 day folks, is disgusting. Foreign policy tree. Yeah, that's all fine. We can form, oh, the 8 all, oh no. Rest assured, we'll not be doing that. And here, of course, is the, non-beardist public controllers tree, effectively. No. Possible questions of the day, or I mean, it's got to be the Irish Economic Advancement Act, doesn't it? Now, time to unmute the game. Here, of course, is A&H, that's Altair na Hesheraga, Knights of the Rebirth, ACA, that's Army Comrades Association, yeah, Pat Ott. I think we have the Mauser 98B. Yes, yes, as our primary rifle.
All in!
German World War I tank division. My God. What are we doing with ourselves? We have a decent roster, don't we? For our high command. I believe we do, anyway. Yeah, we do. Oh, wow, it's actually been expanded quite significantly. Remember, JJ was here, Hugo McNeil was here, Daniel Hogan wasn't, Tom McGuire was here, Daniel McKenna was here, Richard McCahy was here, Ona Duffy, Michael Joe Costello got a new portrait, Tom Barry, Liam Lynch, Carl Brugge, yeah. This is all looking very nice indeed. Now, Michael Collins is running the state, so we'll get Carl Brugge in charge. Tom Barry, glorious. Now, what else would we be building other than infrastructure? Oops. Got a couple of submarines. The water looks terrible. Probably, but yeah, we'll just make some place because we don't have many at the moment. That's fine. Any support equipment? No, sir. 18 counter artillery. We'll import steel from the Italians. Where are you? You have steel, don't you? You should do. Yeah, you got a bit. Italian Federation, here we are. We'll be our primary ally this game. And we'll get some tungsten from the Russians. Don't think the Italians have very limited amounts of that. God, the Southern's building nothing. Inside. But that should about do it for the Celtic Union. Also, I would just like to say a quick thank you to two guys on the Kaiser Redux Discord server for providing us with the flags for this series. I would like to thank Farmer Labour Strongest Zionist and Nikkei. Fantastic. Farmer Labor's strongest Zionist gave me the flag, but it wasn't high quality enough, it would look terrible. And then Nikkei suggested that I just combine a dark green flag with just the Altieri Nahasherika symbol, which is a fantastic idea, which I probably wouldn't have thought of if they hadn't have told me it. So thank you to them. It's due to them that we have the proper flags for this series. We would have had one of them anyway, but it would have been quite a bit into the future. It wouldn't have been wouldn't have worked quite as well. By the way, I think this will do it for our first episode, our introductory reading and lore episode. If you enjoyed this episode, please consider liking, subscribing, and commenting down below. If you're looking forward to this series, please let me know. Please give me any other suggestions that you have. Obviously, of course, just in general for series, but as well, particularly in Ireland Kaiser Redux, I very much intend on doing... where are we? Not there. I very much intend on doing probably... I must look at the Reddit post again, but I think two or three paths here. I don't really have any intention of doing any of these democratic paths. I have no intention of doing the Ono Duffy path, because I dislike Ono Duffy. I don't have any intention of doing the Michael Collins dictator path. Either way, I must check out the Reddit posts again just to see all the information. By the way, I shall see you in the next proper episode tomorrow. Or, no, not tomorrow. Later on, yeah. See you then.